Welcome to the January edition of my carp fishing season. Hope you've had an absolutely superb Christmas and you join me. We've got 48 hours at the Park Lake. Haven't been here for about 3 or 4 weeks, so a bit out of touch with it. But we're going to be covering biscuit a week, and we'll also be able to look at how my tactics and how I approach my fishing in January changes, or it may not change. So without further ado, I'm going to unload the kit out of the van, get the barrow out, get it all sorted, push it all the way down to the lake, see if we can find some fish. Welcome to the vlog. This is where the barrow has led us, round to our little swim called the Cold Swim. You've seen me in here a number of times before. If you've been watching the vlogs over the years, you'll see that I do favour this swim in the winter time. We've had some good fish out of here in the winter. I haven't been down for about 3 or 4 weeks, so I thought, well, nothing's really happening anywhere. We'll start off where we left off on our last vlog. So, January. What do we look for in January? How does things change? How does rigs change? How does tackle change? How does bait presentation change? Well, we're going to suss all that out, and I'm going to speak to you about that all tomorrow. It's going to start raining in a minute. We've had so much rain over the last 3 weeks. It's been unbelievable. It's been flooding like you wouldn't believe. The skies are looking a little bit dark. So I'm going to get the kit off the barrow, get sorted, get the bivvy up, get the rods out, and then we shall have a little chat just before it gets dark. See you in a minute, guys. Half an hour for dark. See over there, look, I don't know if you can see it, but the sun is going down beyond the trees. It's looking lovely out there, isn't it? Look at that, looking beautiful. Beautiful in this little corner. Wind's dying down and it's so mild. I think it's about 9 degrees at the moment. It's been about 11 today. Would you believe it? That's crazy for the end of December, isn't it? Coming up to January. This is mad. Normally, this is like, well, I was saying that actually, from memory, the little bit between Christmas and New Year, sometimes you get a little mild spell, don't you? Well, we're having a bit of a mild spell, but this mild spell's been going on for the last couple of weeks, but it's been so much rain in the area, it's been ridiculous. Been a couple of fish out of here, not a lot though, but up the other end. Haven't seen anything, but it's looking spot on. I feel really confident. Mega confident. I've got all three rods out tonight for the first night. I've got two nights. First night, just singles. I didn't want to disturb the area, just in case they're sort of laying up here. I didn't want to fresh it the foam, spot it, get the marker rod out. So I clipped up to one area I know in here, and the other two spots, I've just got a little 2 ounce lead on, pinged it out a couple of times. One's in silt, one's on a hard area. 360 rigs on all three. I've got a yellow, an orange, and a white Northern Special that have been glugged to Bilio, which you've seen in the last couple of videos. And we've glugged and enhanced those hook baits, so that gives me confidence. They've sucked in all that goodness, all that attraction, that I can fish singles. I get a lot of questions from people saying, well, how can you be confident with just fishing singles out there? Well, one, because it's different to what everyone else does. Everyone puts out loads of bait, spots, loads of boilies everywhere, or particles or whatever. So me just sticking, pinging little singles out with little 2 ounce lids, boom, 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 job done. It's just totally different to what the fish are used to, and it gets their guard down. So yes, we've got three of those on, 360 rigs, pinging them out for the night. I didn't want to go through it. I've got a little bait edge tomorrow to show you what I do for January. Now, it can be really difficult to get a bite in January, and they're just picking and picking on the spots on the area. So I'm going to show you what I do with my loose feed and my rigs and everything else tomorrow. We're also have biscuit of the week tomorrow as well. But tonight, oh, that's another thing. Have you noticed something? For those who are switched on, look. What's that? For those that are switched on, that is the tracker bivvy, isn't it? The tracker Brolly, Tempest Brolly, which I've been using before. I was using the HD, Avid HD One Man. So you think, well, where's the HD One Man? Well, I'll tell you the reason why I haven't brought it is because I love it. Don't get me wrong, it's lovely, but it's not going to be cold. And I want that as a bit of luxury where I'm just going to camp, I'm going to sit down, I'm going to zip up, I'm going to put the heater on, everything else. You know, it was going to be that warm these next couple of days. I wasn't even going to bother with a ground sheet, but I thought, no, I'll add the ground sheet. I'll give the Tempest a little airing out, a little run out, shall we say. And yeah, so we've got the Tempest just for something different that we don't need, that bigger bivvy, that more substantial, that little bit more luxury. So we're slumming it this week. This week, for this vlog, we're slumming it. Right, so we're all out. I expect I'm going to stay up late tonight, 1-2 o'clock maybe, to see if I can hear anything, because I reckon that is when I'm going to see him. If I'm going to see him at all, in this swim from previous winters, it's been in the night. So there we go. Right, first night in, I'm going to get tea on, maybe dinner on, and tomorrow we are going to vote on what is, or has been, what you think has been the best biscuit of the year. So I'm going to want you to put down in the comments down below what you think has been not just my biscuit of the year, but what is your biscuit of the year. So you want to start doing that now, actually. In the comments, put down below what do you think should be our, because this is our vlog, this is our Carpenter Seasons, what is our biscuit of the week? Ask your kids, ask the missus, what do you think is going to be biscuit of the year? Right, okay, and then once we've taken all the votes in, I shall let you know in February's one, this is biscuit of the year. Okay, enough of me yabbing on. One last look out there. I'm going to get organised for the night, get sorted, chill out, because I've just been working like a dog. And yeah, hopefully we may have one to show you, or we may even move tomorrow. Lots going on tomorrow. Rigs, bait, moving, biscuit of the week, everything. See you in the morning, guys. Morning. Well, sun's up. I don't know if you see that or not. Is it over there? Oh, sun's up. Somewhere around there. Quiet night. Not a single bleep. Nothing. Nada. Zilcho. Wind's got up. Out there, look. Starting to blow up a little bit now. It's got a little bit of chillier, although we're going to have double figures today. Going to reel the rods in later, and now I'm going to leave them out all day today, and I'll tell you the reason why. It's because earlier on, just before the wind got up out there, I see a couple of head and shoulders about 20-30 yards behind me spot. So things are looking good, even with that wind. They just want to be here, I think. You know, it's a proven area in the winter that they like to be around. I mean, that wind is a little bit chilly, but the sun ain't up properly yet up there. It's only early. As I say, it's going to be double figures today. And I may even change the rigs over to little hinge stiffies or little multi pop-ups. Just put them up in the air a little bit more, 1 or 2 inches up, rather than the 360s, and change over to... Oh, blimey, that wind's getting up a little bit fresh this morning. Change them over to the glugged up lice system, corkball pop-ups that I've been glugging up for the last 3 months. If you remember in the October edition of these vlogs, we prepped a load of auk baits. Well, that was one of the auk baits that we prepped. Okay, that can only mean one thing though. If we leave the rods out all day, we've put the kettle on, and yes, the housewife's favourite, the under five's favourite, is it's time for, yes, biscuit of the week. Look at that. Welcome to this special Christmassy, in between Christmassy and New Year, biscuit of the week. Have a look at these. Now, I saw these at Tesco's and I thought, these are the ones. These are a little bit special, these are. Look at these babies, look. Cadbury Roundies, or Roundy, Cadbury Roundy. There you go, look. Not seen these before, and they caught me eye. They must be new, I reckon. Let me know if you've had them before, what do you think? Oh, look at these, special foil. Look at that special foil. You have to unwrap them. They've got a special little thing on the back there as well. A little sell by date. I can't even get into them. Right, let's try and get into these. If we can, unwrap them. Tap them, unwrap them. If I can get into them. Best diet biscuits going, these ones, but you can't get into them, so you can't eat them. Right. We're starting to get into them. Oh yeah, here we go. Now, apparently these, they say they are milk chocolate wafer rounds. Cadbury Roundy. So we've got a cup of tea. Nothing like a proper cup of tea in my Christmas cup. Look at that, Christmassy cup. Nothing like it with the wind's blowing and it's a little bit chilly. Right, let's have a check these out here. All right. Yep. I think they're going to be doing it on this session. I don't think they're going to last long. They're a little bit like a Kit Kat. In fact, they're very much like a Kit Kat. Look. These aren't going to last long at all. Look at that. Look. Like a wafery Kit Kat they are. There is, if you like Kit Kats, you'll love these. Right. There you go. There's your Christmassy, New Year'sy biscuit of the week, Cadbury's Roundy, milk chocolate. You get 5 in a packet. Oh, yeah, lovely. Check those out, guys. Milk chocolate roundies. Look at that. Check them out. There you go. There is your biscuit of the week. Hope you enjoyed that biscuit of the week. That is the last biscuit of the week for. Let's just change this. A bit dark now. That is the last biscuit of the week of 2019. Now what I want you guys to do is to vote for your favourite biscuit of 2019. What do you think was the best biscuit of the week? And also, even if I didn't review the biscuit of the week that you think is the best one, put that down in the comments as well. We'll see what we believe, and I'll put my what I think was the best biscuit of the week as well down there. But right, on the fishing, and there's something I do in January. I've just reeled the rods in, got about an hour before sunset. As I said, I was going to leave it a little bit later than I normally would do to recast the rods, because I've seen a couple of fish out there. I've actually changed two of the rigs over. Now, I've cut off two of the 360s, brilliant rigs, but I'm going to be fishing a little bit further out. And all I want to do is put one cast out there on the spot, And this time of year, January time, I've always found that a higher pop-up can work really, really well. If the fish aren't interested, water's a little bit cold, you know, they're just not interested in feeding. A higher pop-up, like a hinge stiffy, but I found it has done really well over the years. So I've put 2-inch stiffies on, but what I've done is, because I don't know the area I'm casting to very well, I've taken off the amnesia boom, or the stiffer boom material that I use, and I've gone for a coated braid, tungsten style coated braid, so that it just sinks down. It could lie over any little bits of weed, or, you know, if it's in a little bit of a divot or anything like that, it can lie on the top of it. Rather have a stiffer boom for a proper hinge stiffer, which I love anyway. Brilliant hook, brilliant hooker, you know, so it's a really good rig. Use an Albright knot to connect the stiff part of the hook part, you know, the stiff part of that. And I'm using I'm using the glugged and prepped food bait that's been soaking in that magic liquid, the Minamino and the liquid liver, for the last 3 months. So they'll be kicking out lots of attraction high up, 2 inches up off the bottom, kicking out loads of attraction, and hopefully one of them fish that aren't interested but showed themselves this morning will be able to give me the last bite, the last capture for 2019. Now, in addition to that, what I do also in January that I found works really, really well is that instead of using like little 10 millers like I was using in the December vlog, and glugging them up with the magic liquid of the Minamino and the liquid liver, what I do is I get some 15 mil boil. It's Life System. It's the one, my dedicated winter bait. And I put that through either a food mixer or like the Ridge Monkey Crusher, and I chop it up into loads and loads and loads of different little bits, lots of small particles, because I don't want to feed the fish with boilies. I want to entice them down onto their hook bait. So I chop about a kilo, half a kilo of that up at a time. Then I add those liquids, the mix of the liquid liver and the Minamino. I mix that into a bag, give it a good shake, good mix around, leave that for a couple of days to soak in, and keep on adding, soaking. And I bring that with me, and then I do little tiny little PVA, little like 50 pence a piece PVA bags, stocking PVA mesh bags, tie them up using that higher tract sort of boily crumb, and I attach those to the hook baits, whatever rig I'm using. You can use whatever rig you're using, attach one of those two, bang it out on the clip or to an area. You know, if you see a fish, just bang one of them on, bang out that high tract hook bait. And I found it really, really works well in January and February as well. It works well, but especially January, that boily crumb really comes into its own. It just gives lots of small food items that, you know, that they can't fill themselves up on, so they're more likely to home in on that attraction and go down in your hook bait, wherever, pop up bottom bait, wherever it is. So that's another little edge that I use in January. It's worked really, really well for me. So I've got all three rods out, two on the little hinge rigs, one on 360 on a white Norma Special. That's probably done the best, most amount of bites in the last 3 or 4 months, is the white one. And we're going to give it a go for the last night of 2019. Oh, hello, almost falling over then. Almost stacked it. Look at that, look. Wind's picked up. Looks lovely out there. And I'm especially confident now because I've repositioned the rods out now. Just at the back of where I was fishing before, they've all gone down lovely. And we're angling. And we've seen fish. So you can't say more than that. That's all we can do now. Can't do no more. In it to win it, only takes one bite, as I always say. Sun's going down, I'm gonna get the kettle on, get some dinner on. Hopefully, fingers crossed, we may have one to show you in the night, or it may be the first walk of shame of this carp fishing season's series. But it's January, so, you know, you're gonna get a walk of shame every now and again. Right, guys, see you in the night, I'll see you in the morning.
Morning.
Quiet night for me. Not even a single bleep in 48 hours. Although, it's good to see that I got the location right, because they were definitely out there. I definitely see a couple of fish poke their heads out. And so you can't do no more than that. Gear's all packed up. Just got the barra, bits and pieces, and the rods are on the dance floor. One last chance of 2019. So you've got about half an hour if we've got to pack up. As long as those rods are on the dance floor, you've got a chance, haven't you? So it just leaves me to say, have a happy new year to everyone. Really appreciate you following and liking the videos and my Instagram page. See you for the next video.